What a marvelous day and such an amazing ride. Ha, I know. You're probably thinking why I'm wearing all this gear for just a ride in the park, right? Well, I have learned from my ride last week that it's better to be safe than sorry. Although the nurse patched my wound pretty well, just take a look at this. The blood was light colored when she put on the cotton. But now, it's a much darker color. I have observed that blood can be found in different shades of red. And that got me thinking. Is it possible for blood to be a different color altogether? Like, can blood not be red at all? Blood is a vital component of the human body. It is a bright red-colored liquid. Blood has several components like red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets, and plasma. Now, red blood cells or the RBCs are the cells which are responsible for transporting oxygen from the lungs to different parts of our body. They also carry the carbon dioxide which is generated by the different body parts back to the lungs. White blood cells are tiny cells in the blood that protect the body by fighting against viruses, bacteria, and other germs. Platelets are tiny particles which help in the clotting of blood and stop the blood from oozing out from wounds. Plasma is a light yellow-colored liquid which transports nutrients, hormones, and proteins to different parts of the body. By now, you must have guessed which component of the blood gives blood its red color, right? That's right. It is red blood cells. Red blood cells contain a protein called hemoglobin. Now, hemoglobin carries oxygen from the lungs to different parts of our body through blood. Hemoglobin is rich in iron that binds with the oxygen in our blood. This bond between oxygen and iron gives our blood its bright red color. This is actually very similar to how oxidized iron looks, orangish red. Okay, are you confused? See, oxidized iron is just a fancy way of saying rusted iron. But the gist is, when iron oxidizes or reacts with oxygen, a red color is imparted. However, if blood is kept outside for an extended period of time, it gets darker in color. Now, why does this happen? See, blood rich in oxygen or oxygenated blood is bright red. The blood that is rich in carbon dioxide or deoxygenated blood is usually dark red. So, when oxygenated blood is kept outside, it loses oxygen and thus turns dark red. That is the reason why blood is found in different shades of red. Hey, but we haven't answered our main question yet. Is it possible for blood to be a different color altogether? Let's take a look. Animals such as octopuses, certain spiders, and snails have a protein called hemocyanin instead of hemoglobin. Unlike hemoglobin, which is a protein composed of iron, hemocyanin is a copper-containing protein. The oxygen molecules bind with the copper present in hemocyanin to produce a blue color. Wow! Animals having blue-colored blood instead of red is wild, right? And if you think blue blood is wild, well then, wait for this. Some animals bleed green. Yes, some species of leeches have a protein called chlorocrorin in their blood. The result is a light green colored blood when deoxygenated and a darker green when oxygenated. In fact, even skinks have green blood, but for a completely different reason. Now, like us, skinks have hemoglobin in their blood too. yet their blood is not red. Leave a comment below if you can find out why. Submarine worms have violet blood too. Now, this color is caused by a different respiratory pigment called hemerythrin. Hemerythrin contains units which contain iron atoms. When deoxygenated, the blood is colorless. But when oxygenated, it is a bright violet pink. So, blood is not always red. It can be blue, green, or even violet. Whoa! That's quite colorful for blood, I'd say. Isn't it fascinating that blood can be of so many different colors? But again, I don't want to get injured because it hurts irrespective of the color. I better get going. I still haven't finished my goal for the day. See you later and ride safely.